The Uganda Parliamentary Press Association President Moses Mulondo, who petitioned the Committee of Human Rights, faced the security agencies and pinned them over gross human rights abuses meted against journalists by security personnel.
Violations have continued. According to the latest World Press Freedom Index report, which is international, as a country, Uganda, we have actually declined. And we have moved from position 115 to position 125. According to the HRNG report of press freedom violations in Uganda, the latest, which was issued a few weeks ago, 131 violations happened last year, and more than 70% of them were mainly by Uganda police and UPD.
Mulondo told the committee how journalists suffered the wrath of security agencies in the 2021 general elections. He underscored the torture and destruction of gadgets that journalists went through in line of duty.
They are concerned about the image of these institutions that year in, year out, they keep violating press freedom and the rights of other citizens. And they have not come up with any strategic plan to address these challenges and end the violations. We would like them to make a commitment today.
A security officer who is doing something against human rights, that person should be held as a person and he should be personally responsible. I wish that statement could be given to, I can see a fund. I wish he could make these statements regularly on press conference.
The UPPA president further accused UCC for collaborating with RDC's upcountry to frustrate media programs, especially political talk shows that were hosting opposition candidates.
The interferences have continued regarding RDC's. On many occasions, all of us have seen incidents, especially when it comes to opposition politicians, when especially upcountry radio stations, when they are scheduled to appear on talk shows, and the RDCs give directives to the station managers not to host those politicians. Concerning the issue of the welfare, journalists are extremely paid poorly.
However, in their response, the Minister of State for Security, Jacob Oboth, assured the committee that security is going to take appropriate action against security officers who perpetuate violation of press freedom. They distance security agencies from human rights violations, saying institutions don't condone torture.
Officers in government who could have violated human rights. The Honourable Chair calls for balancing of rights. Human rights calls for dual responsibility. I wish we could be accorded this opportunity, Honourable Chair, through you, that to give this day the relevance, we get the petition.
As journalists, every Monday, to tell them what we go through and how we want to do things, and how they are done. So there has been an engagement. IGP has ensured that police, as an institution, must relate with journalists in order for the public to be informed.
The UPDF Chief Legal Officer's Brigadier General Godard Businje disclosed that the force has compensated some journalists who were brutalized in recent operations, but this was contested by the journalism body.
They were taken to court, tried and punished. If there is need for attaching the details, then it can come in other submissions to the committee. But she also allow me to add that after the CDF then had organized the football match and dinner with the media fraternity, he tasked me to discuss with the lawyers who are representing the journalists who had gone to court.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.